Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is a e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Okay. Then you see that there is a defect over there. It is not working. For example, you try to click on the account summary and then the transactions are not getting displayed. So you should not, you know, directly report it as a defect immediately. You are testing, okay, the step you are testing, you click on the account summary, you see that no transactions are coming up. Immediately you should not report it as a defect. Whenever you see any step is not working, okay, you got to repeat it like 2 or 3 times. Re-execute the same step again, okay, 2 or 3 times. Confirm to yourself, you know, that it is really not working, okay. If possible, take another test machine or, you know, another test environment and try to execute the same step over there. If it is not getting executed anywhere, if you are very much confirmed that it is a defect, then only report it to the developer. Okay. Maybe sometimes, okay, it can happen that you might have not executed the step properly or you might not have followed the precondition properly. Correct? Are there the possibilities? Let's say you are doing the testing at the end of the day. It is already 5 o'clock. You try to test it. Okay. And then you see something is not working. You should not report it immediately as a defect. Okay. You have to check it. Okay. Try 2 or 3 times the same step, same computer. If it is a little bit something you feel that it is a major defect, take another machine. Okay. Another test machine and do the testing there. And then only report it as a defect. Clear everybody? You should not report the defect right away. Yes, might be the understanding of the data is not correct, or you might have missed certain precondition, or there could be some problem in your system, in your test environment, there could be some problem, right? So you should not directly report it as a defect. Okay. And what is this reproducible? Reproducible means you are executing the same step like twice, thrice, 4 times. Even then you are able to see the same defect again and again. It means it is reproducible. Okay. See, there are 3 possibilities. What are the 3 possibilities? One thing is the defect has occurred. Okay. And it could be due to you did not look at the precondition maybe, or you might have missed certain step. Okay, it may be due to you that the defect this can occur. This is one possibility. Second possibility is, okay, and also even if your test environment is not proper, these are the possibilities. Okay, the defect is occurring, okay, because there is really a defect, but it is not occurring very frequently. Sometimes it appears, sometimes it doesn't appear, okay. It is behaving in a weird way. But you are sure that there is a defect and there is no problem in your computer or your precondition or a step. But it is appearing unexpectedly. In sometimes it's appear, it's sometime it doesn't appear. So there are that kind of defect, which are called as non-reproducible defects. Okay, sometimes you cannot reproduce them very frequently. So this is one kind of defect. Okay. And there are some defects which are, like, you know, getting frequently reproduced. So we say that they are reproducible defects. Okay. So now if they are reproducible defect, okay, you got to put it as why. If even after executing the same steps thrice, 4 times, you are getting the same error repeatedly again and again, put that it is reproducible. Okay. Okay, Raji, this is a defect. Okay. Defect or a bug, it is one and the same. Error is different. Okay, error is, you know, like in the beginning when the person commits a mistake, that becomes an error. But defect and bug is one in which, you know, the application is deviating from the existing expected result. Okay, we call it as a defect. Okay, then tell me the status. We have gone through the defect life cycle, you remember? Tell me the status. New defect? It is a new defect, not open defect, Sangeeta. We are reporting the defect for the first time. So it's going to be new defect. Okay. Okay, Pavni, you want the definition of a defect? See here. And the application or software deviates from the expected behavior, we call it as a defect. Or let's say expected behavior and actual behavior are not matching, then we call it as a defect. Okay. Yes, Jaya. If it is reproducible, you got to keep it as Y. Then, what is the browser that you used? See, if you are using Internet Explorer, you write Internet Explorer, Netscape, Netscape. If there are some anything others that are available, you can add it. Only if it is web application. If it is Windows application, there is no question of browser at all. Okay. Detected by Alex. On what date it has detected? It has automatically taken up today's date, so I need not modify it. Language, this is nothing that we can modify. What is a priority? See here, we have two things, priority and severity. Okay, what is priority? Okay, see, what is priority? Priority is something that is related to the time, and then severity is something that is related to the how much it can affect the system. One second, okay, let me check. Okay, I'm sorry, today we are having a little bit of disturbance. Okay. Okay, so we were talking about the priority and the severity over here. So what is priority? It is something that is related to the time. Means how quickly your client wants the defect to be fixed. Okay, or how quickly they want the release of this functionality, that decides the priority. Okay, and what is severity? Severity is nothing but how much it is affecting the system. Means let's say, for example, if login is not working, what happens? Your entire system gets affected, correct? So that is called as severity. How much it is affecting the system. But if account summary is not working, it's only the transactions are not getting displayed. Let's say your fund transfer is not working properly. Again, we can have the different categories there. In case your fund transfer, it is not displaying something, it is not giving the confirmation, you try to transfer, okay. Your amount gets transferred, but you don't get an acknowledgement. It is a high severity, right? Your money is getting transferred and you are not getting the confirmation, you don't know whether it is transferred or not, it becomes a high severity issue, correct? So you got to decide the severity based on how it can affect the system. Priority is decided based on how quickly your client wants the defect or the defect to be fixed or the requirement to be released. Okay? Is it clear, everyone? Okay? Okay then. So we will choose the priority over here and then we will choose some severity. Subject I can select here. What is the subject I got to select? This is let's say related to the bank. So I select the bank over here. Click on OK button. Do you see? Then we got to mention the description. Let's mention the description. I'll do one thing. I will mute myself because there is some noise and I don't want you to get disturbed. I will type it here and you observe it. Okay. Are you sure, Roshali, you can't hear anything other than my voice? Okay, what about others? Don't you hear any noise from my side? Okay, yeah, then thank you. But I'm getting disturbed because there is some renovation that is going on. Yeah, so that's why. Okay, then fine. For me, that's okay. Anyways, there is slight noise, but it is okay. Amanda, thank you, Amanda. Okay, so the precondition over here is the account should exist. Okay, let me write over here. Okay, what is the precondition? The customer should have the active account. Not just an active account, active online account, right? So he should have an active online account in the bank and successfully log in into the account. Okay. This is a precondition. Alright. Then, what is the step that we are trying to execute over here? We are trying to click on the account summary. Okay. I can say account summary button. Okay. Then what is the expected result here? The expected outcome is the transactions should be displayed on the same window. And I got to write very clearly. How many transactions? The latest 20 transactions should get displayed on the same window. And what is the actual outcome that is happening here? Actual outcome, or let's say the defect that we have here is the transactions are not getting displayed. Okay. Then, is this clear, everybody? How do we create a defect? Any doubt? Okay. See, Shukla, we are trying to, you know, provide as much as information that is possible to our developer. Okay. So the more information, yeah. That is true. Okay. If it is deviating from the expected and then, you know, actual, that is a defect. I agree. Okay. But the more information you provide to the developer about the defect, he will be able to find it more quickly.
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.